Decided on opening a restaurant because there was the niche for it. We did not have African restaurants as at that time, and so I just thought, why don't I start something to cater for African customers? So that was the beginning, and then I had also a passion for cooking, and I also like hosting people. So I went to 8.5 years after that, here we go. It's a bit tough. It's a bit different from what I knew from my experiences as a business person in Ghana. And here you have to do everything according to the book. And even more.
Another man tomorrow. My brother, which kind of life it is? Everybody getting always to follow. But you know easy, yeah. Even if you don't get money, yeah. They jolly, they shake body. No need to the tear body.
Can you pinpoint one or two specifically challenges and major challenges that you actually went through? And I can actually say this is it.
One of the biggest stumbling blocks is attracting customers. And I don't know if it's right to say, but I think we Africans don't really support each other. We've heard about what they call the Jewish coin. Once a Jew gets a coin, he makes sure it goes round in the society. But Africans don't have that kind of thing. We tend to think, okay, I'll buy today from him, or I'll come to his place to enjoy, but then tomorrow, I'll go to some other place. That's no matter where that person's background is from. They'll always go everywhere just to get their enjoyment. They never really support each other. I can remember when I started the restaurant. In the first month, 2 separate days, I did not have a single customer coming in. And that's very disheartening, knowing that you have about 50 to 100,000 Africans living in Den Haag, and that was very tough. You ask yourself if you have taken the right decision.
So that brings us to what kind of customers you get.
I have been very lucky. I don't know if it's about the concept itself, or if it's something new. I've got I'm very lucky to have both customers, like Africans and Europeans. Basically, I've got much more customers from the UN. And I think that has got something to do with myself as an African, and also to do with the earlier customers that I have, and also to do with the Africans who work with the union. I think they feel a bit homesick. And once they come here, they continue to travel. Mentors, if I should say it, mentors are people I consider to be those who really support the restaurant, the idea, and it could be financial, it could be like social, and it could be also other things. I have had people coming in and out, and most of the time you have some people coming in feeling so much at home, they become my brothers, they become my my friends. I could say they are my soulmates. Even when they leave the country, or even when they travel to other places, they keep on calling, I also call them. And they support the place so much. When they have money, when they don't have money, when they are sad, when they are happy, they will support the place. So the safari is supposed to be a very home-based restaurant where people can always walk in and feel at home. And that is the main theme. Although it's a very African-related thing, I think Europeans come and they also feel so much at home. They keep on coming, they come with their family, they come with their friends. And I think we are happy with the basic concept.
I swear you too fine, check any time in for the club they went, check all the guests they go want to die. Mama no mommy can honey, hey. If not lie make you ask if I, so many chicks they might come they love me. Ooh. But now only you who can be my wifey, hey. I dey pray, I dey cast and bind it, hey. For anything we go make us fight it. I don't go lie, it's a man of mindy, hey. You be the best quality of wife.
Tell us about the African community in the Netherlands.
Yes, the African community also at let's say the sub-Saharan African community, because we have the Moroccans and they have been established here already, but we talk about sub-Saharan Africa. I think it was a Ghanaian-Nigerian thing, but now with all these diverse African countries and African people coming in, people from all over, Burundi, Rwanda, Mauritius, Angola. And for the first time in my life, I've met all these people because I'm privileged to have a restaurant like this. The future of this restaurant depends on fellow Africans much more than the other communities like Europeans. Africans should be able to go out, enjoy themselves, not only to think that when they go out they make money for the person they're going to visit, let's say like here as a restaurant, but then to know that they're going to interact and have the good networking that we all need, and then it's going to bring that I know is going to bring prosperity to the African community as a whole. Food I cook here is basically very general West, East, and some South African countries. And we had originally doing West African food. Some along the line we had all these customers from the east and some from the southern parts of Africa. And we decided why not serve the whole thing as a whole. And so you have people combining West African food and East African food. Everybody enjoys. We also met so far. I think I can truly say has made my life so rich. It has been the best period of my life, and especially my adult life. It has been really the best part. Every single day I meet different people, I talk to different people, I get different ideas, and then you cannot exchange it for anything. If there's something that I would like to change, it would always be the African mentality as to supporting each other. I think we need to do much more for ourselves. We have to come together, help each other, and make sure we prosper, just like every other people's.
Thank you very much for this. I hope you can do more of this.
Yeah, thank you very much. I also like being showcased as an entrepreneur, as a restaurateur, and also as a friend of everybody, especially the African community. Thank you.
What song did you sing?
When you see a underground,
Ademado, Mado, Ademado, Mado, Peso, Peso, Adiverso, Peso.
From now,
see my eye, I'm a idolat, I'm a see my eye. Hey, idolat, idolat, hola, I'm gonna feli feli. See yes, me do, I'm gonna go no kelly kelly. I'm a Tony Telly, I'm a Tima Tony Telly. They see me on the telly, they lock my biggie belly, biggie belly, biggie belly, biggie belly. Yes, I'm black and I got the biggie belly.